Say cheese. Hey, what's cracking, good people? What's cracking? What's cracking? What's happening up in this joint? What's happening up in this joint? All that fire and the pressure was needed. I have to stay focused. Hey, look, everyone has a journey. Everyone has a journey. Never judge a person. Don't be so quick to judge people. I thought we'd grow together. In my heart, I show it. That man makes plans, but only God can know it. I keep praying, and is he listening? Why they keep praying on the innocent? I'm waiting on the images. Man, this is weighing on my innocence. God knows I can either wait or turn militant. Crossroads, either divisive or be diligent. Either be righteous or belligerent. The choice is gonna be scrimmaging. I just wanna be what he calls. You know, I feel sorry for women that really has time to like have these like silly cat fights, you know, that look for to bring another woman down. I actually find it tasteless and disgusting. I find it stupid and not classy at all. There's so much happening in this world. There's so much chaos happening in this world, and I look at females. I'm just talking about females because I'm female. Don't hang around guys so much anymore because Kinyetsi, so that's just how it is. But I used to prefer hanging around with guys because there's just no drama, you know what I mean? I married my best friend, you know what I'm saying? So it's just so sad that another woman will actually bring down another woman or find something to make sure that another woman isn't too many women. Woman no crime. I just don't have time to like play around. Like, I don't have time to entertain people with like bad hearts. God needs to teach me how to deal with spirits like that. You know, I have great discernment. I can tell somebody with a negative dark energy a mile away. And but you know what, when you can see that one is like negative and dark and whatever, that's fine. But it's those ones that pretend, that like smile with you, and they act like they're Christians. But they, oh yes, that's it. You know, there's iniquity. There's two different sins. There's like sin, what's the meaning of sin, and the sin of iniquity. Now sin, if I had to take, let's say this didn't belong to me. Like what? This phone didn't belong to me and I took it. I committed a sin. But if I'm sitting here around a table and I'm like, hey, and deep inside, I don't like you. That's iniquity. That's a deeper worst type of like, it just rubs me the wrong way. Where am I getting to with this? I just don't understand why people can't be kind to each other. I just don't understand it. I just don't understand it. I don't understand why women can't fix each other's crowns. I'm just really blessed that the friends that I have, they're more like sisters, and we carry each other through thick and thin. And that's also, that's a choice. That's a choice. You make a choice. You decide. You see, people, there's a saying, I don't know how to quote it the way it's, but you say, you know a person by the people that she hangs around with, right? So, like, people find me fascinating. People find me, they call it extra now. People find me amusing. People easily get intrigued by me. And that's not just being proud or anything like that. As you know what it is, it's because most, not everybody, is that everybody is so busy copying other people's lives. Everybody's so busy afraid to be themselves. Everybody's so busy being so fake that they feel that their authentic self, their original self, who God created them to be. If you can tap into the space of who you really are, truly are, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. And people always go, you're happy. You know, you are just something else. And I'm like, no, it's not that I'm something else. It's because you are something else, because you're not being yourself. That's what it is. So I love people. I've said it many times on my clips, and people that know me know that I love people. But also I have a calling and I have a gift, and because I am surrounded by people in my daily life, I give a lot of my love, right? But also I come across spirits that are dark, and that because I am an empath, and I can sense a person's energy. Sometimes that stuff can weigh me down. And I'm the type of woman that when something doesn't sit well with me, I don't fake it. I will tell you exactly who you are and what spirit you are, you know? What spirit you carry, or I just push myself away from you, you know? I'm telling you, there's so much going on in this world. You need to focus about fixing yourself. The minute you look at your aura. Hey, Sokoa is coming out of the door. You need to look at your kamahari. And you see that actually the problem is not that person, the problem is me. And you need to do some soul searching. You need to do some soul searching. I'm telling you that once you figure that out, you will be happy with the person that you've become. So, I've been spending a lot of time in prayer. I'm spending a lot of time with God because, you know, I always tell people, until you know my story completely, until you've walked in my shoes, you will understand why I'm crazy about God the way that I am. I believe in change. I believe that a person can change. I used to be that person, and I don't want to talk, I'm not ready to talk about my late brother. I'm not yet. That's why when people come to me with like silly issues, and they just come with like negative vibes, and I know that every day is a battle of me trying to be a better person, and I'm trying to strive to be a righteous person. And then I'm gonna have some silly Billy Willy come act a fool. I'm like, I ain't got time for that right now. Move. Move, fool. So I believe in change. And change doesn't happen like this. And the only way that you can change to be a good person or righteous person, you need to allow God in your space. Not Pilates, yoga, traveling, or people always say whatever works for you. I'm telling you, you're missing the point. You can do all those things, but you're still gonna, your soul's still gonna be empty because it is not complete. At the fast rate that I was going in this world with the things of the world, I was going so fast. The pace that I was going was so fast that I ended up becoming the walking dead. You need to remember that I started clubbing back in Pretoria when I was 11, 12. And I was like one of the youngest. I was the youngest in the clubs. Not only that, I was a person of color because back in PTA Central, where I grew up, there weren't blacks yet. The blacks were still in the township because of apartheid. My dad just, us being exiled, being from exile, we just happened to get into the city in the burbs. But that came with a price. And that was being in a space where there's a different culture, different people. So I had to grow up very quickly. So I watch people doing things now, right? And then if I go back, I can always remember that, you know what? I did that back then. It's got nothing to do with age that I've changed. It's just got to do that it was God's time and I made the choice, right? So when I got to 26, so much between the space of when I was born to the age of 26, there's a lot of chaos that happened. I was just that girl. I was out there. I was using my power for the wrong reasons because I knew God had given me this power where I could attract a lot of people. But a lot of people took so much away from me, but I didn't know. I didn't know that until I got spiritually into God's arms and I realized that I was so selfish because I was using this gift that I have for my own purpose. So the change began when I fell pregnant with my daughter, my first daughter. And how I fell pregnant, no, not how I fell pregnant, the situation at the time when I was pregnant with my daughter, I was addicted to heroin. I was addicted to crack cocaine. And I have been in serious relationships before, two long relationships. But at that time, because of the chaotic space that I was in, the trauma that I experienced as a child when I was a lot younger only caught up with me in my 20s. So then I became melancholy. And almost like the walking dead. So I became from that fun, loving, party animal, like everybody wants to be happy, I want to be around happy, to this person that became melancholy. And my everything was crack cocaine and heroin. Back then, if you saw a black girl smoking heroin, it was taboo. It didn't happen. It's not as big as it is now. Right, so I always thought that because I was in this two relationships, I knew that I'm a marriage material. I spoke about that before, but life happened. I lost it completely. Anyway, so my daughter is the one that basically made me have this U-turn where I made a decision to make the choice of happy, or you're gonna destroy your life, destroy yourself by living this chaotic life, or are you going to try and give this child that you have in your womb a future, a chance? And I cannot tell you step by step what God did in my life. I just made that one choice. That one choice that I'm going to stop all my nonsense for this child. So basically, my firstborn is the one that saved my life. And that's when the change began. The change towards my heart, towards God. I began to gravitate myself to. So I was never, it was never in the church. It was in my circumstances and what I've endured in this life. So I began to gravitate towards God. Even though God was always there for me through it all. I always say this. God doesn't come in your life when you only get saved. Guys, like, God is such an amazing God that you could see, like, if I think about everything that happened in my life, you can see his hand, like, him sending his angels over me, So God has always been there. So because of that out there person that I used to be, I stopped doing things. Now, people always think that, oh no, you know, why do you stop doing this? Why do you stop doing that? Why do you stop doing this? I personally stopped doing the things that I do because of my love for God, right? He does not judge you. That's not what I say. If you're going to drink and overdrink yourself and get drunk, there are consequences that you're going to face. If you're going to do drugs, there are consequences that you're going to face. If you're going to do something that is not of God, there's always consequences. It's got nothing to do with God punishing you. It's just the choices that you made that you need to pay the consequences for, right? So, I'm an extremist, so meaning that even though I hate labeling, meaning that when I did use drugs, there was no stopping for me. I was gonna go and 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 go. The only reason that I'm alive today is because of God. Nothing else, right? So that is why I do not drink. That is why I don't. And also, it's got to do with my parents. I come from a family that never drank, never smoked. So the only, as I grow older and wiser in God, I understand that the things that I do was because of the circumstances that I was in. But because of the parents that I was given, as strict as they were back then, it was like a headache for me. When I look back, I'm like, okay, now I understand why I am the mother that I am today, why I am the wife that I am today. Because my mother only married one man, and that was her first love. My father passed away, she never remarried again. So meaning I do have that in me to be with one man and be good to that. To it's in me because it's in my mother's, it's in the bloodline of where my roots are come from. So that plays a big role as well, I believe. So, you know, like for instance, I don't go out at night. Again, it's a personal choice that I made. I've been going out. I got the t-shirt a long time ago. I don't go out at night. I don't have a problem with people that go out at night. There's just something in the spirit and in the air that happens during the night that I don't want to be in that space. Going for an innocent movie is fine. I prefer in the day. It's just my personal choice. At night, I prefer to be at home, either with my family or in prayer or spending time with God, because these eyes have seen so much in the outside world, in the dark world, that when I step outside, I know both sides of the world because I've lived them both. You feel me? Yes. So, you know, like, we have to take the things of God seriously. We have to take the things of God seriously. We really do. We really do. We have to stop this thing of hating one another, being jealous of one another. Like, I'm not there. I wish, I need to have the heart of, if I see somebody that's not a good person, I have this thing like, you know, I grew up like street. So already if somebody comes to me like with beef and stuff like that, which is usually not the case, but if you feel that, hey, this one's got a negative space, then I've got this like Like, it's such a strong presence that I have of, like, you don't want to mess with me. Again, not because I'm a fighter. No, it's just because street, if you grew up street, that's how we are. We, you know. But I don't want to be that person. I want to just be full of love, 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 love. God will take care of the enemy. It's not my job to take care of the enemy. It's not my job. My job is to love. We need to love. We need to love. We need to love. We need to love. I cannot say it. I cannot stop saying this. God is love. I love because God loved me. And that's why I love. Anyway, that's all I could say for now. And whoever watches my things, thank you for watching my things. I really appreciate it. I really do. It's not about the likes or the subscribe. If I can change one person's heart, if I can bring them closer to Yeshua, to God, then I've done my job. I've done my job. It's not about, oh, let's check Happy out, whatever, what you're talking about now. It's all about, okay, I hear what Happy's saying. What Happy's saying is that there is a God. There is a God, and God is real. And the story about Jesus is real. And I want to try this God out. I want to try Jehovah out. It's not complicated. Religion has made God complicated. Complicating. Religion, they've messed it up. Have a relationship with God. Encounter, have an encounter with God. You'll see, it's beautiful. Man, look at me. Huh? God loves a person like me, and I'm far from perfect, but I'm perfect in God's eyes. I'm confident like this, not because, like, that's how I is. I'm confident like this because I know who my daddy is. I know who my creator is. Peace and light. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Seek ye first. All these things that we go through, like, I go through stuff, guys. But it's a lot easier because I have God. The things that I go through is a walk in a park. If I didn't have God, it'd be chaos. Complete chaos. So try God. It just makes this thing called life a lot better. And it's beautiful. Like, I'm spoiled. He spoils me. I ain't gonna lie. He does. He's my daddy. He said, I will be a father to the fatherless. And that's exactly what he's doing. Right? Peace out. Be you. And don't be Fong Kong. Be you. Don't be afraid to be you. Don't worry about the namesayers. Naysayers. Namesayers. Naysayers. Hey. You see, I'm getting Gugile now. The slang that I used to talk back in the day, it's kaput. All these kids are coming up with all kinds of words. But anyway, I'm always going to be like this, man. This is me. This is who I is, man. And God loves me just the way I am. I try to live a righteous life. And I'm so grateful to God that He loves me. Glory be to God. Peace.